थ्योरी ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस है, इट इज GOC 3, थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ GOC है, थ्योरी ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस। बॉयस, इन आवर ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री एसिड्स एंड बेसिस आर देयर, ऑलरेडी वी कवर्ड बॉयस। सो कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स, COOH ग्रुप्स एसिड्स, phenols acids, sulfuric groups acids. Okay, in our organic chemistry also acids are existed, acids are exist, and also bases, amines, basics. Boys, we covered the strength of acids and bases at the time of inductive effect. Boys, please check once again, inductive effect also explain the strength of acids and bases, number of nitrogenous compounds, basic nature, COOH, acidic natures, all those are covered at the time of inductive effect. So those are also here available, those are also here in our syllabus. Some part is completed at there, okay, remaining part I am covering here. Now before entering into the acids bases theories, in our physical chemistry we know what are acids, what are bases. There are different theories to explain this acids and bases. Among them, Arrhenius theory, Lewis theory, Bronsted-Lowry theory. These are the three theories to explain which one is acid, which one is base. So there are theories and different theories. Let us recollect the concept. After that, I'm entering into the organic chemistry, acids and bases. So take this concept, boys. That is theory of acids and bases. So there are three theories, boys. One is Arrhenius theory. Arrhenius theory. Okay, according to Arrhenius, what is acid, boys? Any substance where it is dissolved in water releases H plus ion. In aqueous solution, H plus ion giving substances are called as acids. If OH minus ions are coming out in aqueous solution, that is basic. So according to Arrhenius, acid is a substance. So acid is a substance that liberates H plus ions in aqueous solution. Any substance which releases, which liberates H plus ions in aqueous solution is an acid. Let us take an examples. Example, HCl, H2SO4, HNO3. Okay, HClO4. All these are acids, boys. They release H plus ion when they are dissolved in water. This is acid. Already we covered in ionic equilibrium, boys, theory of acids and bases. Now, what is base according to Arrhenius? A base which liberates OH minus ions in aqueous solution. Only in aqueous solution, boys, which releases OH minus ions in aqueous solutions. That is base. So example, NaOH, KOH, CaOH twice, BaOH twice, all these are releases OH minus ions when they dissolve in water. Right? That is why these are acids, these are bases. They release H plus ion, they release OH plus. So this is according to Arrhenius, acid base theory. According to Arrhenius, which release H plus ion in water, that is acid. Which release OH minus ion in water, that is base. Next, there is another theory, that is Lewis theory. Lewis acid base theory. What is this Lewis theory? According to Lewis acid base theory, any substance that can donate electron pair to others is a base. Which can accept electron pair from others is an acid. So here, so acid is nothing but electron pair acceptor. Acid is nothing but electron pair acceptor. This is acid. So any species that can accept electron pair is considered as acid. Next, base. What is base? It is electron pair donor. Electron pair donor is base. Electron pair acceptor is an acid. Let us take an example. See here, boys, I'm taking NaH3, na, nitrogen has lone pair, AlCl3Ne, aluminium has empty orbital. This lone pair is donated by that nitrogen of ammonia and accepted by aluminium of AlCl3. So it is electron pair donor. It is electron pair acceptor. This is base according to our Lewis. This is acid according to our Lewis. According to our Lewis. That gives NaH3 to AlCl3. A coordinate covalent bond is formed, boys. That means it exists as NaH3 plus ion, AlCl3 minus ion. AlCl3 minus ion. So this is electron pair donor, therefore it is base, it is electron pair acceptor, it is an acid. So electron pair acceptor is an acid, electron pair donor is base. Just I am recollecting, boys, I am not explaining complete theories. Okay, so this is Arrhenius theory, this is Lewis theory. So next and most important theory in our organic chemistry generally we use is Bronsted-Lowry theory. Bronsted-Lowry theory. What is this Bronsted-Lowry theory? So these two theories are frequently used in your organic chemistry, boys. Please keep in mind. What is, according to Bronsted-Lowry theory, acid. So it is proton acceptor. Acid which can donate proton. Proton donor. So not only in aqueous solution, in any case, in any situation, if it donates proton, proton is nothing but H plus ion, boys. H plus ion is called as proton. If H plus ion is donated by that substance, not only in aqueous solution, in any solvent, that is possible, that should be taken as acid. Next, base is nothing but proton acceptor. That is H plus acceptor. Which can donate proton is an acid, which can accept proton is nothing but a base. Okay, that means a proton transfer takes place between acid and base. So acid donates proton, there base accepts proton. There is a transfer of proton between acid and base. Okay, so next here a common example is there. That is, see here. I'm giving an example for this one, boys. See here. That is, HCl plus H2O. HCl plus H2O. This HCl donates a proton to H2O and converts into Cl minus ion and H3O plus ion. Cl minus ion and H2O. Boys, this HCl is proton donor. This water is proton acceptor. Okay, so therefore proton donor is nothing but acid. Proton acceptor nothing but here water acts as base. Okay, if it loses its H plus ion and converts into Cl minus ion, so it is acid after losing H plus ion and converts into Cl minus ion. So this is considered as a conjugate base. C base, nothing but conjugate base. Conjugate base of this chemical end. Because it is a base, it is a conjugate acid end. Conjugate acid of this base. Okay, there is an equilibrium reaction takes place between acid and base. There is an equilibrium reaction. So this reaction takes place, that one takes place this one. Here Cl minus ion acts as base. Here H3O plus ion acts as acid. Now this can donate H plus ion to this one. So it is a proton donor, it is a proton acceptor and converts into like this. Okay, so any substance which can donate proton is called as acid, which can accept proton is called as a base. Okay, so that means this is HCl, this is Cl minus. So between this HCl and Cl minus, there is only one proton is different. So see here. So HCl, acid, Cl minus, conjugate base. That means between these two, only one H plus is different. Only one H plus is different. So next, once again, H2O, it is a base. Its conjugate acid is H3O plus ion. So it is a conjugate acid, boys. So between these two also, only one proton is different. The pair of acid base, which differ only one proton, is considered as conjugate acid base pairing. Very, very important, boys. So this is the term frequently used in our organic chemistry. What is conjugate acid base pair? An acid base pair differ by only one proton. Only one proton. If only one proton is different, that is called as conjugate acid base pair. Conjugate acid base pair. Okay. So, sir, how to gauge conjugate acid or conjugate base for a chemical, for a given chemical, boys? Because it is acid, boys. So to this, H plus ion is removed, gives conjugate base. If base is given, H plus ion is accepted, that gives conjugate acid. That means, so if a substance is given to you, how to get its conjugate acid or its conjugate base? So see here, boys. That is, if a substance acid is given to you, minus H plus ion gives its conjugate base. Okay. So if base is given to you, plus H plus ion, the proton is added, that gives conjugate acid. Removal of H plus from a substance gives its conjugate base. Addition of H plus to a substance, it gives conjugate acid. So this is very, very, very important. It is very, very, very important. Okay. So acid, its conjugate base. Base, its conjugate acid. That means this substance, either it is ion or neutral, whatever it may be. Okay. This is coming from this one. So that's why it is a conjugate of this one. Okay. So acid and its conjugate base differ only by proton. So loss of hydrogen, gain of hydrogen. Loss of hydrogen gives base. Gain of H plus gives acid, boys. Gain of H plus. Okay. So this is very, very important. Now let us identify. Let us try. I'm trying to explain. I'm trying to write some substances, conjugate acids and conjugate bases. Let us start. So there is a question, boys. Take a question. Write conjugate base for the following. Write conjugate base for the following. Please try to write. This is my question, boys. Write conjugate base for the following. Now see here, H2O. Try to write. H3O plus ROH2 plus ROH RNH2 plus NH2, not NH2, it is NH3N. RNH3 plus. Try to write it their conjugate bases. So conjugate base, he asked base. That means the given substance is acid. So if you want to get base, given substance minus H plus ion gives conjugate base. Given substance minus H plus gives conjugate base ones. Remove H plus ion from base. Minus H plus gives OH minus. It is conjugate base. It is conjugate base of H2O. From this, remove H plus ion. Remove H plus ion. That gives H2O, boys. So this is conjugate base of this one. Next, once again, remove H plus ion. That gives, when H plus is removed, boys, ROH, it becomes neutral. This is conjugate base of this one. Next, from this, remove H plus ion. That gives RO minus. This is conjugate base of this one. Next, minus H plus gives RNH2. So these are all corresponding conjugate bases. These are all corresponding conjugate base. So how to get conjugate base? Conjugate base, it is obtained by the loss of H plus from the corresponding acids. It is conjugate base. Now how to get conjugate acid? Addition of H plus to the substance gives conjugate acid. I'll take some examples for that one also. So next my question is, because these are very, very important for our further study in our organic chemistry. You must know about conjugate acid, conjugate base. That must be required, boys. Write conjugate acid for the following. Write conjugate acid for the following. Now see here. First one, OH minus. Second one, RO minus. Third one, RNH2. Fourth one, benzene with OH minus. Next, this is phenoxide. Next, RCOO minus. Next, HCOO minus. Boys, try to write their conjugate acids. Write yourself. How to get conjugate acid base, acids and bases? So substance minus H plus gives conjugate base. Substance plus H plus gives conjugate acid, boys. So given substance plus H plus gives conjugate acid. Now he want to find out their conjugate acids. I'm writing, boys. So add H plus to this one. That gives H2RO. It is the conjugate acid of this one. Add H plus to this one. So ROH boys, it is conjugate acid of this one. So add H plus to this, that gives RNH3 plus, it is conjugate acid. Add H plus, that gives, so just it is a phenol boys. So it is conjugate acid of this one. Next, H plus gives RCOOH. H plus gives HCOOH. So all these are boys. All these are conjugate acids to the corresponding chemical set. Conjugate acids. Let us try some more examples. Let us try some more examples. COO minus, right? It's conjugate acids, boys. Conjugate acids. Yes. All right, their conjugate acids. Write yourself. I'm trying to write. Next. Complete it. Write conjugate acids. Add just S plus, H plus. Now H plus is added, boys. That gives COOH. Benzoic acid is conjugate acid. Now it becomes, it is H plus is added, boys. OH, alcohol. SH, thio alcohol. NH, one more H plus is added. NH2 minus N. NH2 minus. These are all conjugate acids for this chemical, boys. Okay. So, is there any doubt, boys? To find out conjugate acid and conjugate base for a given chemical, is there any doubt? If you know this conjugate acid and bases, now let us go to explain how to find out acidic strength and basic strength of the chemicals. Okay, so now take a subheading. acidic strength and of acids. Acidic strength of acids, boys. How to explain acidic strength for acids? Boys, see here, I'm taking an acid. Let us take HA is an acid. So let it be HA. It is an acid. Okay? So if now it is acid, that means it releases H plus 2 others. It releases H plus 2 others. I'm taking water. So this releases H plus 2, this one. That gives A minus ion and H3O plus ion. This is the reversible reaction, guys. Okay? Any substance which quickly releases H plus ion to others is a strong acid. Any substance which quickly releases H plus ion to others is called strong acid, boys. Okay, that means if it releases H plus ion, when compared to HA, A minus, it is nothing but conjugate base end of HA. So if this reaction takes place, so it is more stable than HA if the forward reaction takes place. Am I correct or wrong? If A minus is more stable than HA, forward reaction takes place. Because when products are more stable than reactant, then only the reaction takes place. That means, so if it behaves like an acid, no doubt, when compared to HA, A minus conjugate base is more stronger than HA. Then only that releases H plus ion. Now that HA is considered as an acid. That means, so acidic strength of acid is depending on stability of conjugate base. Am I correct? So acidic strength of an acid depends on stability of its conjugate base. If conjugate base is more stable, that is ready to form, that is why it's acid, ready to give H plus and easy to convert into its conjugate base. Easy to convert into a strong base, a conjugate base. So did you catch my point, boys? If conjugate base is more stable, because that product is more stable, conjugate base is more stable, that HA ready to convert into A minus. That means easy to give that H plus and converts into HA minus. That means acidic strength of HA. Acidic strength of acid depends on stability of its conjugate base. If conjugate base is more stable, it is easy form. Because it is easy form, it is ready to donate that H plus. Therefore, acidic strength is directly proportional to stability of conjugate base. It is very, very important. Acidic strength of an acid directly proportional to stability of conjugate acid. So did you catch my point? This is one of the factors that explains stability of acid base in future. More is the conjugate base is stable, easy. That corresponding acid is a very, very strong acid. So therefore, acidic strength of acids is directly proportional to stability of conjugate bases. Next, one more example. Because it is reversible reaction, there is an equilibrium, boys. So because wherever equilibrium is there, there is equilibrium condition. Because it is acid, dissociation of acid, that means it is called as equilibrium condition Ka. So for that, Ka is equal to A minus ion concentration into H3O plus ion concentration to HA concentration, because water concentration is always correlation, boys. So Ka, which is called as dissociation constant of acid. So if Ka is more, A minus is more. A minus more means HA lesser. That means HA is ready to convert it. Therefore, So acidic strength is directly proportional to Ka value. That is the dissociation coefficient of acid bonds. Acidic strength is directly proportional to Ka. That means more is the dissociation coefficient of acid, more is the stability. Therefore, acidic strength is depending on Ka values and stability of conjugate base. If Ka is there, we pKa. pKa is nothing but minus log Ka boys. So automatically, Ka is more, pKa is less. That means inversely proportional to pKa values. Less is the pKa, more is the Ka. More is the Ka, more is the acidic strength. Therefore, finally, acidic strength of acids is directly proportional to stability of conjugate base, Ka value, and inversely proportional to pKa value, boys. Inversely proportional to pKa. Did you catch my point, boys? It is very, very, very important. Now, there are some more factors which are trying to explain more acidic or less acidic. That is acidic strength, boys. See here, for example, there is a COOH, boys. This is COOH. There is COOH. If it releases H plus ion, minus H plus ion, and converts into COO minus ion. Okay? So, it is a conjugate base of this acid. Am I correct? If this conjugate base is more stable than that of this one, this reaction is taking place. This reaction is taking place because it is more stable than this one. Sir, how to explain? This one is more stable, this one is less stable. See here, boys. So, I am writing it is carboxylic acid. Right? It is a carboxylate ion. This is carboxylic acid, that is carboxylate ion. Now I am trying to explain both these chemicals, species. So resonance structures, I am taking carboxylic acid, boys. So C double bond O, OH, oxygen has lone pairs, boys. This lone pair is here, this pi bond is here. That is in resonance with C, O minus, OH, this one gets positive charge, that one gets negative charge. So this is double bond. Boys, here ions are available. So it is a carboxylic acid. These are the resonance structures of carboxylic acid. Boys, in resonance structures of carboxylic acids, ions are operating, that to opposite charge ions. So next, I'm writing resonance structures of carboxylic acid. See here. C double bond O, OH double. This is O minus, boys, carboxylate ion. So this carboxylate ion, this oxygen has two lone pairs, boys. This is migrated here, this is migrated here. That is in resonance with CO with minus charge, double bond O with two lone pairs, boys. So only one charge, that two identical structures are. These two are identical structures. Identical resonance structures. Identical resonance structures are more stable than non-identical resonance structures. That means when compared to this resonance is more stable. That is why this carboxylate ion is more stable than this one. That means it really loses its H plus ion. Therefore, carboxylic acid is less stable when compared to carboxylate ion. That is why carboxylic acid COOH gives H plus ion. Therefore, COOH is treated as an acid. Because it releases H plus ion and converts to more stable carboxylate ion. And converts into more stable carboxylate ion. That's why COOH is acidic. Now, see here. I'm trying to give some groups attached to that carboxylic acid. When that COOH is ready to come out. See here, boys. COOH. To this carbon, if electron withdrawing group is there, to this COOH, if electron withdrawing group. So this electron withdrawing group absorbs that electron pair towards this one. Automatically carbon losses its electron. So this carbon try to extract electrons from oxygen. Now oxygen trying to extract hydrogen electrons from hydrogen. So that means this electrons ready to give ready to attract electrons towards this oxygen. That is why this hydrogen is released as H plus very easily. Very easy. That means if electron withdrawing group is attached to this carboxylic group, that means some carboxylic group. So the electron is here on carbon, first of all decreases. That is compensated from oxygen. That is compensated from hydrogen. Now this hydrogen is released as H plus. That means when electron withdrawing group is there, so that H plus is quickly out. Am I correct? Boys, am I correct or wrong? Tell me. If electron withdrawing group is there, that electron withdrawing group decreases electron density on carbon. That carbon compensates from oxygen. That oxygen compensates from hydrogen. Now hydrogen free from electrons, ready to come out. Therefore, electron withdrawing group increases acidic nature of this carboxylic acid. Correct or wrong? Electron withdrawing group increases acidic nature of this carboxylic. That means whenever electron withdrawing group or minus I group, whatever it may be, minus I group or minus M group, whatever it may be. Okay. So if these are there. So hyperconjugation also there. Hyperconjugation. So no doubt. So these increases acidic nature. Therefore, acidic strength of acid is also directly proportional to strength of electron withdrawing group. No doubt. So directly proportional to electron withdrawing group. That is nothing but minus M, minus I, and hyperconjugation. All these gives. So minus M and not hyperconjugation, minus M, minus I, that's enough. And inversely proportional to electron releasing groups, that is plus M, plus I, and plus hyperconjugation. That means acidic strength of acids directly proportional to first point, stability of conjugate base, next point, Ka, dissociation constant of that acid, and inversely proportional to pKa of that acid. Less is the pKa, more is the acidic nature. Boys, so acidic strength, acidic nature of acids are clearly explained on the basis of pKa values, boys. More is the pKa, less is the acidic nature. More is the pKa, less is the acidic nature. Okay? So, pKa inversely proportional to pKa. So, electron withdrawing group is attached to that group. That means acidic nature increases. Electron withdrawing group, that is nothing but withdrawing group, boys. That is minus M, minus I groups are nothing but electron withdrawing groups we are considered. So that means minus M, minus I groups increases acidic nature. Plus M, plus I groups donates electron signing. So that's why it decreases acidic nature. So this is all about how to identify which one is more acidic, which one is less acidic. That is acidic strength compared to study of acidic strength of acids, boys. Okay. So this is very, very, very important. If you know these concepts, let us identify some examples. Okay. Okay, boys. Let us compare acidic strengths of some acids. Okay. So take the question. Compare acidic strength of following acids. Okay, first example, boys. See here. CH4, NH3, H2O, HFN. CH4, NH3, H2O, HFN. See here, boys. In all cases, hydrogen common. Other elements are, what are those other elements? Those are nothing but, here carbon, here nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Okay. See here, boys. Carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine. These are same period elements. These are same period elements, boys. If period is the same, use electronegativity cases. So apply electronegativity concept. So acidic strength is directly proportional to electronegativity of that element. So acidic strength directly proportional to electronegativity, boys. Tell me now, answer. Which one has more electronegativity? Which one has less electronegativity? We know fluorine is more electronegative. Next oxygen, next hydrogen. After that, carbon ending. So therefore, it is more acidic. It is less acidic. Therefore, order is 1 > 2 > 3 > Sorry. So this is more electronegative. This is less electronegative, boys. Therefore, 1 > 2 > 3 > 4. So more electronegativity, more absorbing tendency. More absorbing tendency, automatically H plus is easy to out. Therefore, so here HF is more acidic. HF is more acidic. Next, second example. Second example. Now, HF, HCl, HBr, HIl. HF, HCl, HBr, HIl. Okay. So now, here boys, H is common, but fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Okay. So this is organic, boys. This is H. I'm generally comparing from initial to, and we are going towards organic. We are going towards organic. This H. Okay. So whenever these acids are there, now see here. So these are, that is, what are those? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. These are same group elements. Same group elements. Now compare sizes. Same group elements are there. Now compare sizes. Okay. So therefore, so acidic strength directly proportional to size of that element. Acidic strength directly proportional to size of that element. Now, this one has more size. This one has less size. Therefore, this is more acidic. This is less acidic. Therefore, once again, 1 > 2 > 3 > 4. Therefore, HA is more acidic than HA. HI is more acidic than HF. Here, intermolecular hydrogen bonds are there, boys. Because of that, it is not possible. That means hydrogen bonding plays an important role. So here, HI is more acidic, HF is less acidic. Now, let us see. So one more example. Now, I'm entering into the organic acid. So CH3OH, boys. CH3SH. CH3SH, CH3NH2. Now tell me, so CH3 common, H common. The different element is oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen. Oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen. So oxygen, sulfur, same group elements. Nitrogen is before group. Okay, oxygen, sulfur, same group elements. Now tell me, which one is more acidic? Actually, oxygen is more than that of nitrogen. Yes, correct, boys. That is, see here. So, sulfur is more than that of oxygen. Therefore, so I'm taking this one as A, B, C. A, B, C. Which is highest end? Yes. So that means top to bottom acidification. So here oxygen is more, here sulfur is more. Therefore, B greater than A greater than C. This is our organic end. This is C, boys. So this is alcohol. This is alcohol. It is a thioalcohols. It is amine. Boys, thio alcohols are more acidic than alcohols. Very, very, very important statement. Thio alcohols are more acidic than alcohols. Thio alcohols are more acidic than alcohols. This is important. Okay. Now we are entering into the organic compounds. Now, is this organic or something else? Tell me. Who is that? Is this organic or not? Next one, OH COOH. It is fourth one. Boys, this is called as a phenol. This is called as a carboxylic acid, which is nothing but benzoic acid. No doubt, boys, benzoic acids, alcohol, that is carboxylic acids, are more acidic than phenol. Very, very, very important. Okay? So, therefore, phenols are less acidic than carboxylic acids. Phenols are less acidic than carboxylic acids. So, because in carboxylic acids, identical COO minus and identical structures are possible, but not in phenol. So, COO minus ion is identical resonance structures. But not phenolic. Therefore, so this conjugate base is more stable than this one. This conjugate base is more stable than this conjugate base. So therefore, this is more acidic than this one. Next. Next one. OH, that is nothing but alcohol. OH, no doubt alcohol. OH, boys. Tell me. Which is more acidic, which is less acidic. Boys, these are alkyl groups. Alkyl group is plus I group ending. Alkyl group is plus I group. Here one alkyl group. Here two alkyl groups. Here three alkyl groups. That is two plus I groups. Here three plus I groups. As number of plus I groups increases, tell me. Plus I groups is inversely proportional to S6 strength ending. Okay. Therefore, 1 greater than 2 greater than 3 ending. S6 strength is inversely proportional to plus I. And S6 strength is inversely proportional to number of plus I groups. And directly proportional to minus I groups. See here. Next one. OH. Cl, Cl. OH Cl Cl. Tell me, boys, which is more acidic? So this is our OH. It is very near at 2. These are minus I, boys. It is OH. So it is on second carbon, minus I. But here is more distance. It is less distance, boys. As distance increases, I effect decreases. Minus I increases the acidic nature, but distance is more. In this case. So therefore, here minus I less, here minus I more. Therefore, it is more acidic. It is more acidic. 1 greater than 2. So, next. OH, Cl, 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 OH, yeah, boys. Tell me, boys, which one is more? Here, minus I is more. Here, minus I is less. More minus I, more acidic nature. Therefore, it is the order, boys. Okay, 2 is more than that of 1. So 2 is more than that of 1. So more minus side, less minus side. So minus side directly proportional to its strength. Next. SO3H+ sulfonic acid. So this is carboxylic acid. Boys, please be conscious. Sulfonic acid is always more acidic than carboxylic acid. Sulfonic acid is always acidic than carboxylic acid because here more identical resonance structures, less identical resonance structures. More resonance structures gives more stability. Any therefore. Its conjugate base has more identical structures. Its conjugate base has less identical structures. Therefore, sulfuric acid is more acidic than carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid is more acidic than phenols. Is more acidic than phenols. Okay, it is sulfuric acid. It is carboxylic acid. It is a phenol. It is phenol. Please note down the names also. Next. See here, boys. Here, hydrogens are there. These are the two. Let us take HA. Okay. So, HA. Next. Here also two hydrogens are there, boys. I am taking HB. Is HA or HB is more acidic, boys? Tell me. Is HA or HB is more acidic? From where? Hydrogen is easy to out. HA or HB? See here. If it releases this H plus ion, it becomes negatively charged ion. It is its conjugate base. Now, if it releases its H plus ion, it becomes like this. Okay? These are conjugate bases, boys. If this one is more stable, this is more acidic. If this one is more stable, this is more acidic. And now tell me, so among these two anions, these are conjugate bases. Among these two anions, which one is more stable? Boys, this is aromatic. This is aromatic. This is anti-aromatic. This is aromatic. This is anti-aromatic. So more stable, less stable. Therefore, it is more acidic than this one. Am I correct? It is more acidic than this one. This is correct or wrong? Tell me. So this is the way to identify it. If you directly it is not possible, identify its conjugate base. So, if conjugate base is more stable, then corresponding acid is more acidic. If conjugate base is more stable, then corresponding acid is more acidic because acidic strength is directly proportional to stability of conjugate base. Stability of conjugate base. So, these are conjugate bases. Okay. So, this is more stable than this one. Therefore, this is more acidic than that. So cleanly, clearly, slowly, mind with your mind, please identify the strength. Okay, acidic strength directly proportional to stability of carbon ion, directly proportional to Ka, inversely proportional to pKa, directly proportional to minus M minus I, inversely proportional to plus M plus I hyperconjugation. These are the factors. By using this, we can identify which one is more acidic, which one is less. That is, we can compare acidic strength of different acids. Now, see here, phenol wise. Phenol, this one bonded with NO2 group, OH, OCH3 group, OH, This is a Cl. Just OH. It is bonded to CH3. Cl. It is better to go with the Cl. I'm going to compare Cl and A, B, C, D, E. Tell me, boys. Identify. It is minus Emra. This is minus Emra. This is, for halogens only we consider minus Ira. For OCH3 at para position, plus M and minus Ira. This one has no one. Tell me the order. Tell me the order, boys. This one minus M, this one minus M. So as minus M is more, strength is more, more is the signature. So my answer is, here it is the greatest one. It is the greatest one. So A greater than, next chance this one. E greater than. So here minus M plus M raw, it is minus M boys. So that is why minus M dominates. So that is why C greater than B, sorry. D greater than B and because here plus M dominates. Here plus M dominates, it is nullified. Okay, so therefore it is plus M, it is no M. Therefore our answer is A, E, C, D, B. Okay, did you agree, boy? Did you agree with me? Because here plus M is stronger than minus M. So in case of methoxy group, plus M dominates. Here, halogen only we consider minus I. Only we consider minus I. Okay, next one. OH, NO2. OH, NO2. See, boys, I'm explaining here. So this is orthonitrophenol. This is paranitrophenol. Orthonitrophenol, paranitrophenol. In orthonitrophenol, so see, this is the structure, boys. Okay, so between this hydrogen and oxygen, intramolecular hydrogen bonding is possible. This is intramolecular hydrogen bond, boys. Because of that intramolecular hydrogen bond, this hydrogen is not free. Not free. Okay, but it is not possible here. So this hydrogen is free. But this hydrogen is not free. So now this releases as H plus easily when compared to this one. Therefore, it is more acidic than that. So this is very, very, very important, boys. So this is very, very, very important. Okay. So see here, its pKa value. Its pKa value is 7.1. Its pKa value 7.2. Less is the pKa, more is the acidic reaction. So pKa value is 7.1, pKa value is 7.2. So this is somewhat more acid than this one. So it is due to intramolecular hydrogen bonding. That plays an important role. That is why that hydrogen is not free, not released as H+. Boys, remove always hydrogen from high electronegative element any, not from any others. Next, one more example. See here. OH, phenol. This is NO2. OH, NO2, NO2. OH, NO2, NO2, NO2. This compound is called as picric acid, boys. This compound is picric acid. Tell me, boys, among these three, which one is more acidic? NO2, electron withdrawing group. As the number of electron withdrawing groups increases, acidic nature increases or decreases? Among these three, which one is strong acidic? Which one? 1, 2, 3. Which one is more acidic? Which one is more acidic? Among 1, 2, 3, which one is more acidic? How? Yes, yes, Pawar, you are correct. Sidhu, correct. No hydrogen bond operates, boys, because so here one NO2, only one NO2. In case of single NO2, hydrogen bond plays an important role in it. Hydrogen bond plays an important role. So, but here more number of electron withdrawing groups. So this OH is free to outed. That hydrogen is free to coming out. Therefore, as the number of electron withdrawing groups increases, acidic nature also increases. Therefore, this one less than. So boys, picric acid is the strongest acid in it. So it is almost behaves like ordinary acid. It is always almost behaves like ordinary acid. That is very, very strong acid, picric acid. Okay? So in phenolic compounds, that is the strongest acid. Okay? Next. OH, I am taking NO2 at meta position, boys. OH, I am taking that NO2 at para position. And only OH, boys. Phenol. A, B, C. Tell me, boys, which one is more acidic? Yes, boys, here only minus I affected. Here minus I, minus M affected. We know every condition, boys, at ortho and para, minus I, minus M applicable, but at meta position, only minus I is applicable. So M dominates I, boys. Here M dominates, here I end. Therefore, this is more acidic than this one. Here more electron withdrawing tendency, here less electron withdrawing tendency. Therefore, B greater than, no doubt NO2 is there, A greater than C. B greater than, A greater than CN. Okay. Next. This is HA, boys. This is HB, boys. Is HA is more acidic or HB is more acidic? Is HA, this hydrogen is coming out easily or that hydrogen is coming out easily? Which one is more acidic? Yes, correct. Check once again as per your aromaticity also. See here, boys, if this one loses H plus ion, this one gets negative charge. See here. This negative charge here, this negative charge here. So now this carbon becomes negatively charged. So it becomes aromatic. For example, if it loses its negative H plus, then this carbon negative. This is like here. This is like here. Now this carbon gets negative charge. Okay, but it is anti-aromatic. So among these two, which one is more stable, boys? Is this first one or second one? First one or second one is more acidic? Sorry, more stable. Aromatic or anti-aromatic? So there is anti-aromatic compound. This is aromatic compound, boys. Now tell me, after losing, this is conjugate basis of those acids ending. These are conjugate basis of those acids. No doubt, aromatic compound is more stable than this one. Therefore, one is easily formed than that of two. Therefore, so first one is more acidic ending. This is more acidic than that one. So did you understand the concept, boys? So finally, which one is more acidic? One or two? One is more acidic than two. One is more acidic than two. This is very, very, very important. Okay. Next, some more examples. Some more examples. This is the comparative study of acidic nature of some phenols, boys. Okay, see here. That is C triple bond CH. Boys, this carbon is in sp hybridization. C double bond CHH. This carbon is in sp2 hybridization. C single bond CHHH. These are sp3 hybridization, boys. Tell me, 1, 2, 3 among these three, which one is more acidic? So here S percentage is 50 ra. Here S percentage is 33 ra. Here S percentage is 25 ra. As S percentage increases, electronegativity increases, minus I nature increases. Okay. Yes. So that means this is more minus I, this is less minus I, this is a, so therefore, so sp hybridized, this one is more acidic than this one. 1 > 2 > 3. So this is important, boys. As s percentage increases in hybridization, so electronegativity of that carbon also increases. So that means minus I tendency also increases. Therefore, would be careful, boys. So this is one ion. So as per IUPAC system, one ion, that is, there is a hydrogen with a triple bonded carbon. That hydrogen is acidic in nature. One ions are acidic in nature. One ions are acidic in nature. Okay. Now, see here, boys. HCN and C triple bond CHHN. Among these two, which one is more acidic? Among these two, which one is more acidic? Yes, one. So this is more minus side, less minus side. It is. Therefore, first one is that. That means hydrogen cyanide, right? It is HCN. Hydrogen cyanide is more acidic than acetylene. This is acetylene, boys. This is acetylene. Hydrogen cyanide is more acidic than acetylene. Now tell me. This is phenol. It is a cyclohexanol. Among these two, which one is more acidic, boys? This is phenol. This is cyclohexanol. No doubt, phenol is more acidic than cyclohexanol. Phenol is more acidic than cyclohexanol. Now, Once there is hydrogen, it is HA. Let it be HA. It is HB, boys. Now tell me. First one or second one? Yes, second one. HB, that is more acidic. After losing this H plus ion, see boys, see here. After losing this H plus ion, this becomes negative end. See here, boys. This is our benzene, boys. Now, this becomes aromatic. This is aromatic. This is aromatic. This is aromatic. Because of that, the H plus is quickly out, ready to convert into aromatic compound, stable conjugate base. Stable conjugate base. Therefore, that is more acidic than this one. So, aromaticity is not applicable here. So, because these two are not connected. So, therefore, this HB is more acidic than. HB is more acidic than HA. Okay. So, these are some examples towards acidic nature of phenols and some other cases, boys. Tomorrow we will discuss acidic nature of carboxylic acid and derivative of carboxylic acid. So next class we will discuss, boys. Right now I am stopping this concept here. Thank you.